Welcome to my channel Sarah Cooks for You. Today we are making the Queen of Arabian Deserts, that's Punafa, and it is really a royal and a supreme desert of the Middle East. And it's so simple. I think it's the most simplest dessert I've ever made. For this, I've used kunafa dough that's ready made. You get it in long strands. You need to separate out this dough and break it into smaller pieces. You can also do it using a blender. If you don't have this dough available in the country you live, you can also use any kind of vermicelli for this. I'm adding 2 tablespoons of melted butter to the dough, kunafa dough, and we are going to rub it in nicely so that the dough gets covered with the butter. We'll be adding some in the serving dish also, so just about 2 tablespoons is enough for this. Take a serving dish, you can also use a spring foam for this, and I've added about 1 tablespoon and a little bit more, and apply this all over the serving dish. Now gently start adding in the kunafa dough. The bottom of the serving dish has to be completely covered without any gaps. And as you add in the dough, make sure to press it down with your hand, and you also need to cover the at least half of the wall of the serving dish. Now here's the interesting part. I'm using cream along with mozzarella cheese. This is generally filled with just the mozzarella cheese or the Arabic cheeses, the sweet cheese or the Akavi cheese. But here I'm using a mixture of fresh cream and mozzarella as my filling. So I've used, sorry, it's the heavy cream. I've used about 300 ml of thick cream or the heavy cream, so that when the mozzarella cheese gets cold, when you add just the cheese, it tends to get a bit rubbery and you can't eat it when it gets cold. So when you do this, it gives a better texture to the kunafa, and it also adds to the taste. I'm also adding mozzarella cheese, about 150 grams. You can add more according to your choice. If you want a stretch in your kunafa when you cut it, you need to add in more of the mozzarella cheese. And once you're done with layering the heavy cream and the cheese, you need to cover it up with another layer of the kunafa dough. Make sure you completely cover it and press it down gently so that if any filling comes up, then you can cover it again with some more kunafa dough. This is the most tastiest dessert, and it's so simple. It's already ready to go into the oven. So we'll bake it at 180 degrees. It takes about an hour or so. And in the meantime, let's make the syrup for the kunafa. For this, I've used 1.5 cups of sugar and I've added 1 cup of water to it. It's a simple sugar syrup, and to this, we'll just flavor it with a bit of lemon. I've just squeezed a bit of a lemon, and we'll also add in some rose essence or rose water to this to flavor it. And cook the syrup till it boils once, and the sugar syrup is ready for the kunafa. In the meantime, my kunafa is also ready. I baked it at 180 degrees for about an hour, 45 minutes to an hour. You can also do it on the stovetop if you don't have an oven. It's really very simple. Once it's done on the bottom, you need to just flip it over and cook it on the other side as well if you're cooking it in the pan. And once it's out of the oven, when the kunafa is hot, you add in the sugar syrup and garnish it with pistachios, ground pistachios in whatever design you like. And the amazing and really very simple kunafa is ready.